Let us pray. Prayer leader shared today with us, and I really did appreciate that. It is a privilege to be able to take your concerns, your burdens, your requests, your desires before the Lord of hosts. It's a privilege. We are privileged people this morning. We're privileged people. Father in heaven, how grateful, how thankful, how in awe we are to be in your presence this morning. We're grateful, Lord, because you don't have to, but you condescend to men of low estate. Even though you have created all the worlds and all power is in your hands, we praise you today because, Lord, we have come to know you in a very real way. We praise you, God, because not only are you a problem solver, but Lord, you control everything. And a problem to us is simply a problem solved to you. You're divine, you're holy. You are wonderful, and there is none like you in all the earth. Words cannot adequately express your greatness, your character. Words cannot adequately express the love that you have for us, but you demonstrate that we have this morning to make connection with you. Lord, I don't take that lightly. Lord, I'm grateful, I'm thankful. I love you today because you first loved me. You found me in spite of myself. You loved me in spite of myself. And Lord, before we ask you for another thing, we just want to say thank you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. I know we don't sound like the angels around the throne, but truly, Lord, we praise you this morning. Teach us how to praise you better. Teach us how to recognize who you are. Teach us how to come before your presence, bringing you gifts out of our own spirits to show gratitude that we know who you are. Because truly, you are the wonderful, masterful God of the universe. Now, Father, many of us have come because we have things in our lives that need working on. We have things in our lives that we cannot fix ourselves. We have unanswered prayers and we have desires that we've been struggling with for quite some time. Lord, we have brought them to you before and really we're at a loss as to why our prayers haven't been answered. We ask that you would teach us how to get into your word, not only your word, but to get into your presence, Lord, so that we can connect with you, so that we can hear from from you. So that when we get up off of our knees, when we come out of our prayer closets, we will know that we have heard your voice and your voice alone. Thank you, Lord. Now, Father, we ask that you would remember the sick at this altar, the sick and afflicted who couldn't make it out today, that you would touch their bodies, that you would heal them, place your healing hands on them in the mighty name of Jesus, and turn that situation around so that they can complete their assignments for you and represent you in the earth, so that they can bring you the highest glory. Lord, help us to remember that the enemy cannot touch us unless you give them permission. And when you bring us out, you bring us out so that we can have a testimony and glorify you. Help us to understand that you don't answer our prayers because it's all about us. You answer our prayers because it's all about you. And as soon as we make up our minds that for God we live and for God we die, many times we can't expect anything from you. But Lord, help us to have a determination today that as we recognize your soon coming, we are going to live for you, withholding nothing, totally surrendered, withholding nothing. Jesus, we ask it. And for his glory's sake alone, amen.